dial in to wait to hear, ooh, when did the bridegroom come? Ooh, what happened? What happened? Imagine the bridesmaids dismissed when they're chosen to this place of honor, and the bridegroom comes, and they're stuck outside the door, and the bridegroom says, I don't know you. Now, they probably did know the bridegroom, or at least they knew of the bridegroom, or they wouldn't have been invited and given that place, right? But knowing about the bridegroom is not enough. A vital part of being ready is knowing the bridegroom directly, personally. Understanding that the bridegroom may show up at any time. They knew about the bridegroom. They came and brought their lamps, but they didn't know enough to be fully prepared. They didn't take the bridegroom seriously enough to be fully prepared. So then they asked their sisters, their friends, to help. But they can't help. Or they would be taking their own preparedness seriously enough. It's basically Jesus is saying there are some things that no one else can do for us. No one else can have a relationship with Jesus Christ for us. Not our parents, not a pastor. Only ourselves. Now, another thing that we talked about when we thought about being prepared was all the storms. You know, we just got through this Hurricane Ida coming through, and we thought about all the different things that we've been through here in North Carolina with Fran, Floyd, and so many others. But particularly, we remember Fran and Floyd. I can remember right here coming and having worship outside in the little turnaround. How many of y'all were there for when we had worship outside in the turnaround because we had no power in the church? And we put up a big whiteboard, and we put on the whiteboard for our community, for our neighbors. We put up, have need. So I have a chainsaw. Well, I need a chainsaw. Okay, great. I've got bottled water. I need bottled water. We did that. For our community, we reached out. In the early days of the pandemic, people were buying toilet paper off the shelves like crazy because they were trying to be prepared, even causing shortages. The idea of trying to prepare for a storm, trying to prepare for something that's coming and we know it's going to be bad, can fill us with fear. To this day, when a bad storm is coming through, we'll go downstairs and sleep on the couch. We hold each other through the night, afraid of what we might find in the morning. But still, we have forecasts for storms. We do know, to some extent, when they come, and some idea of what things might come. Jesus is making it clear that the kingdom of God is somehow unpredictable. And the only way to be ready for it is to get ready right now. I mentioned that in the previous chapter, Matthew 24.